Hello everyone. Today the topic for presentation will be sterilization in orthodontics. I'll start with the introduction. For protection of both the doctor and patient, sterilization techniques are of utmost importance in preventing the spread of infectious disease. This is of special significance in dentistry because more microorganisms are found in the oral cavity with the increasing number of adult patients and diverse lifestyles. The orthodontist is more at risk than ever to exposure to serious pathogens and must take precautions to guard against the transfer. Modes of transmission: from patient to practitioner, from practitioner to patient, from one patient to another, that is cross-infection. Infection control in clinical area. PPE stands for personal protection equipment, environmental surface cleaning and disinfection, instrument, sterilization, disposal of waste. PPE, which is personal protection equipment, consists of protective clothing, gloves, masks, protective eyewear. Protective clothing protect worker from exposure to contaminated materials. Gloves. Gloves should be used while touching blood and body fluids, mucous membrane, non-intact skin of the patient, items or surface soiled with blood or body fluids. General precautions while using gloves. Wear gloves for all dental procedures. Discard gloves whenever they have been contaminated. Do not leave the clinic or walk around wearing gloves. Wash hands after removing gloves. Mask. Surgical mask must be worn to protect the face. Should have at least 95% filtration efficiency for particles 3 to 5 micrometer in diameter. Should be changed for each patient since its efficiency decreases as it traps moisture during dental procedures. Eye protection. The eyes of a dental professional are particularly susceptible to physical and microbial injury by virtue of the limited vascularity and diminished immune capacities. Eyes must be protected during operative procedures by spectacles. This is a small video on how to wash your hands properly. Wet hands in the running water. Then apply soap and rub palms together to ensure complete coverage. Then spread lather over the back of the hands. Make sure the soap gets between the fingers too. Grab the fingers to the edge of the hand. And wrap. Pay particular attention to the thumb. Press fingertips into the palm of each hand. Wash thoroughly and dry. Antiseptic hand hygiene agents consist alcohol, chlorhexidine, iodophores, PCMX, triclosan. So what is sterilization? Sterilization generally refers to any process that eliminates or removes or kills or deactivates all form of life, that is particularly microorganisms such as fungus, bacteria, viruses, spores, unicellular eukaryotic organisms, etc. by the means of any chemical or chemical or physical sterilization. Preparation for sterilization: rinsing, debridement, and drying. Rinsing of instruments: soaps, detergents, aldehydes, phenols. Lawrence and Block in 1968 gave an article in which he said that proteins and other polymolecular structures, particularly when dry, serve as protective covering for microorganisms and prevent penetration of sterilizing medium. Rubo and Gardner in 1965 stated that ultrasonic devices act by converting electrical energy vibratory sound waves which pass through a soap solution containing the instruments. Principles of sterilization. It is essential for the sterilizing agent, that is heat, steam and or gas, to be in contact with every surface of each item to be sterilized for the specified period of time at the specified temperature. All sterilizing equipment must be regularly serviced and maintained by suitably qualified engineers. The manufacturer's instructions should be strictly adhered to for its operation and maintenance. Methods of sterilization. The ADA Council on Dental Materials recommends that metals and heat-stable instruments undergo sterilization by either autoclave, chemical vapor, dry heat sterilization. Dry heat and or autoclave is for the metal items. Cold solution gas sterilization is for the non-metal items. Autoclave, the advantages and the disadvantages. It is mostly moist hair. The advantages are the results are consistently good. The instruments can be wrapped prior to sterilization. But the downsides of it are blunting and the corrosion of the sharp instruments happens. It causes the damage to certain rubber goods. Three factors on which the sterilization is based on is the pressure, temperature and the time. Sterilization oval is the for the unwrapped instruments. Temperature is 134 degree, time is 3 minutes, pressure is 30 psi. The wrap instruments temperature is 121 degree Celsius mostly. The time is under 15 to 20 minutes and the pressure is mostly from the 15 psi. Autoclave, porous load autoclave, small bench top. So I'll start with the porous load autoclaves. The porous load autoclaves is for to achieve the complete sterilization. A temperature of 121 degrees Celsius at 20 psi is maintained for 20 minutes. The articles which can be sterilized by this method generally include towels, which is used for draping, suture materials and cotton rolls, rubber gloves and etc. Small portable bench model type autoclaves. For complete sterilization, 130 degrees Celsius at 32 psi are maintained for 5 minutes. The steam entering the top of the chamber penetrates the material in a top to bottom flow. Wrapping of instruments for autoclaving. Instruments must be clean but not necessarily dry. Cassettes, drums, trays with opening on all sides may be used. Packaging used for autoclaving must be porous to permit steam to penetrate to the reach and reach the instruments. The materials used for packaging could be fabric or sealed biofilm, paper pouches, nylon tubbing, sterilization wrap and paper wrap cassettes. Dry heat sterilization, an alternative method of sterilization of sharp instruments. Action, dehydration and oxidation of microorganisms. The advantages, the instruments do not rust. The disadvantages are the process is time consuming. The carbon steel instruments can lose their hardness because of dry heat, according to the article given by Custer and Coyle in 1970. Dry heat sterilization, hot air oven, Cox rapid heat sterilizer. Hot air oven, it is used to sterilize items which do not get damaged by high temperatures, such as laboratory glassware, glass syringes and instruments. Cox rapid heat sterilizer, approved by the FDA for 6-minute sterilization cycle at 375 degree Fahrenheit for unwrapped instruments. Wrapping instruments for dry heat sterilization. The instruments must be clean and dry prior to wrapping. The wrapping material must be heat resistant. Aluminum foil, metal and glass containers may be used in dry heat oven. Glass bead sterilizer. Heat transfer device employs submersion of small instruments such as endodontic files and bars into the beads and are sterilized in 10 seconds provided they are clean. Most of the studies indicated that if the orthodontic bands are sterilized by using glass bead sterilized method sterilizer, 15 seconds is required to sterilize bacteria and 45 seconds required for the spores. So if 5 bands were placed in the bead sterilizer simultaneously, twice the time was required for the sterilizer. Chemical vapor sterilization. Dry heat saturated steam plus formaldehyde kills bacteria, spores and viruses. The destruction due to double action by heat and formaldehyde occurs. Lack of corrosion of instrument, shorter duration of sterilization cycle. The sterilization is achieved at low temperature, that is 73 degree Celsius. Are some advantages of the chemical vapor sterilization. Ethylene oxide gas sterilization, highly penetrative, non-corrosive agent, destroys microorganism by alkylation and causes denaturation of nucleic acids of microorganisms. Excellent sterilizer of heat sensitive items, does not require heat above room temperature. Toxic, allergic, requiring a long exposure time of 2 to 6 hours. Exposure for mixed with air is the disadvantages. Radiation used for sterilization. Ionizing radiation, non-ionizing radiation. Ionizing radiation consists of X-rays, gamma rays, high-speed electrons, and ionizing radiation, ultraviolet, infrared rays. Ionizing radiation is effective for heat-liable items, has great penetrating properties. It is commonly used to sterilize disposable materials such as needles, syringes, swabs, culture plates, etc., which was also explained in the article Advances in Applied Microbiology, Volume 1, 1959. Sorry, it's not an article, it's a book. Non-ionizing radiation, ultraviolet, infrared. Monitoring sterilization, physical, chemical, and biological. These are some parts in which monitoring is done. So, in physical monitoring, refers to periodical observation of displays or galls on sterilizer during a cycle to ensure the sterilization process. Chemical monitoring, process indicators consist of color changing material, which is liquid paper or paper, which changes color upon exposure to appropriate sterilization cycles. In steam, if the paper or the liquid changes into pink, it is for the processed, and if changes into brown, unprocessed. Ethylene oxide, if it changes in green, it's processed. In yellow, unprocessed. Formaldehyde, if changes occurs in pink, it is processed, and in green, unprocessed. TST strips. TST stands for time, steam, temperature. So, the change in color when all parameters have been adequately achieved in all sterilization cycle. Biological indicators. Indicator used are heat resistant bacterial spores. If the spores are killed, then less resistant microbes are killed more readily and sterility is achieved. Disinfectants used in orthodontics. Glutaraldehyde, quaternary ammonium compound, chlorine compound, iodophores, synthetic phenolics. Glutaraldehyde, 20-minute immersion in a 2% alkaline glutaraldehyde solution is for the disinfection, and if you want sterilization, 6 to 10 hours immersion should be done. It's non-corrosive, penetrates blood, pus and organic debris. It induces severe tissue irritation, which is the downside of it. It induces severe tissue irritation upon the prolonged contact. Discolors nickel coated impression trays and carbon steel bars. Quaternary ammonium compound, bactericidal against gram positive bacteria, non irritating, economical, pleasant odor. Inactivated bioorganic matter can sometimes support gram negative bacteria, which is the downside. Easily inactivated by the presence of anionic detergents, soaps and hard water. Chlorine compounds, the advantages are rapid antimicrobial action, effective in dilute solution, economical, but the downsides are the prepared solution has only limited shelf life, activity diminished by presence of organic matter and altered pH, unpleasant odor, irritates skin and eye, can degrade plastic and rubber coated instruments. Iodophores, The advantages are broad spectrum disinfectant, especially effective against heavy viral contamination. Biocidal activity occurs within 3 to 30 minutes, effective in dilute solution. The disadvantages are unstable at high temperature, must prepare daily, inactivated by hot water, may discolor some light colored surfaces. Synthetic phenols, they act as protoplasmic poisons which precipitate the protein and destroy the cell wall synergistic effect instead of additive. Broad antimicrobial spectrum can be used in metal glass, rubber and plasticless, toxic and corrosive. Economical, downsides are not a sterilant, no reuse life, irritates skin and eyes. Surface cover, should materials impervious to moisture on surface, difficult to clean, to be changed between patients, impervious backward, paper, aluminium foil, plastic covers. Spray, wipe spray technique. It can be done on the dental chair and on the chair on which the doctor sits, and on the patients, on the chairs of the patients' waiting area also. Disinfecting dental equipments, handpieces, most are autoclavable, depends on manufacturers. After sterilization, lubrication is mandatory. Handpieces is placed in autoclavable devices. Steps for proper sterilization of handpieces: decontamination inside and outside, rinse, flushing lines, dry, sterilize, lubricate, and bag wrap. Three-way syringe should be treated in the same manner as handpiece. HVE tips, metal tips are autoclavable. Plastic tips must be disposed of after single use. Aspirators, disinfectant flushes for the aspirators should be done after each patient. Sterilization and disinfection of individual articles: alginate, iodophose or glutaraldehyde for 15 minutes. Burrs, ethylene oxide 4 to 12 hours, autoclave. Tungsten carbide instruments, chemical vapor 20 minutes at 270 degree Fahrenheit, dry heat oven 60 to 120 minutes at 320 degree Fahrenheit. Carbon steel instruments, chemical vapor can be done for 20 minutes at 270 degree Fahrenheit, ethylene oxide can be done for 4 to 12 hours, dry heat oven 60 to 120 minutes at 320 degree Fahrenheit. Drake et al. In one article said that plastic items in the heat sterilizable cheek retractors should be immersed in prosaide sterilization solution, which turns milky after autoclaving. Hand pieces and photographic mirrors sterilize in Kevoclave. Pilot racks and instruments are placed in a wire basket and run through an ultrasonic cleaner containing rust inhibiting non-ionic multipurpose ultrasonic cleaner. Ultrasonic solution should be changed daily and covered during cleaning to reduce aerosols. Dried blood must be scrubbed off in repeat ultrasonic cleaning. Heavy-duty nitrile gloves are required for handling contaminated instruments. After cleaning, instruments are dipped in a sodium nitrate rust inhibitor. Autoclave for 20 minutes and 20 minutes for cooling. Causes of sterilization failure. Cycle time too short, temperature too low, failure to preheat, faulty sterilizer, interrupting of cycle, overloading of chamber, inadequate staff training, improper pre-cleaning, packaging, failure to use biological indicator testing. Vendrell et al. Had one article of effect of steam versus dry heat sterilization on the wear of orthodontic ligature cutting pliers. There was no no significant difference in the mean wear at the tip of the pliers between two groups. It appears that there is no need to maintain both sterilization systems, dry heat and steam autoclave, in the orthodontic office. Steam autoclave sterilization can be used with no deleterious effects on the pliers if they are manufactured with stainless steel innards. Smith et al. In the article, the effect of the clinical use in the orthodontic arch wire sterilization on selected orthodontic arch wires. he compared between the new and the used arch wires, nickel titanium, beta titanium, stainless steel arch wire. The sterilization disinfection procedures includes disinfection, steam autoclave, dry heat, cold solution sterilization. So no clinically significant differences were found between the new and the used arch wires. Corrosion of instruments. With solution corrosion, strong solutions such as blood or saliva from the electrolyte and cause corrosion as either an acid or a strong base with debris interface corrosion. Debris such as cement or dried blood sets up a potential difference resulting in electron flow and rust at the edges. Heat itself will not cause corrosion, but it accelerates the process by increasing the rate of molecular reaction. The corrosion resistance of orthodontic grade steel is directly proportional to its chromium content and inversely proportional to its carbon content. No steel is truly stainless, but stainless steel protects itself by forming a protective chromium oxide layer from oxidation products of the alloy. This is one case in which the lip burn from the band seater happens. The band seater was placed in the ultrasonic cleaner for 5 minutes. The cleaning solution contains the sodium hydroxide following thorough rinsing under running water. The instrument was placed in glutaraldehyde solution overnight. So, we found that in the next morning, it was thoroughly rinsed, dried and returned to storage, the instrument. But during its next use, to seat a mandibular right molar band, the patient experienced a painful burning sensation of the lower lip. Within a few minutes, an increased intense edema occurred, creating a soft flattened mass near the right commissure. He found that the instrument had a tarnished area at the junction of the shaft and the handle. On the closer inspection, it was found that a clear fluid leaking from this area and the crystallization occurring at the periphery was there. And this led to suspect that the chemical burn experienced by the patient was caused by the combination of sodium hydroxide and glutaraldehyde leaking from the instrument. Disposal of waste. It should be disposed in tamper-proof containers or boxes. It should be labeled as biohazard, should be in tune with the existing laws of the areas. Sharp material should be stored in a hard walled, leak-proof containers, red in color. Biological hazard. The segregation of the waste in color-coded bags are given by the WHO, in which the yellow bags, we put the waste for the incineration. Infectious waste, bandage, gauze, cotton or any other things in contact with the which generally comes in contact with the body fluids, human body parts. The red bag consists of the plastic waste such as injections, syringes, tubings, that is IV bottles and etc. In the blue bag, all types of glass bottles and broken glass articles, outdated and discarded medicines are there. In the black bag, needles without syringes, blades, sharp and all the metal articles and the normal household waste is discarded. Here I finish with my presentation. The references for my presentation are as follows. Thank you.